Our big story this morning, John McCain has suspended his campaign to focus on the economy and right now not going forward with the debates until something is hammered out. Is this a sign of leadership or political maneuvering? Join us right now. We got radio talk show host Michael Reagan and Mike Papantonio. Guys, good morning to both
of you.
Morning.
How are
you? Morning.
Michael, let me start with you. I was reading in the New York papers today, some Democratic insiders are calling this a brilliant move on John McCain's part. They say, quote, going back to Washington is what presidents do. He is acting like a leader. What do you say, Michael?
Well, I'll tell you this. It's a sign of weakness is what it is. McCain wanting to suspend his campaign is saying, I don't want a debate. Look, here's the problem.
No, they're going to debate, Mike. They will do a debate. They're just postponing it for right now.
I understand. Right now, the reason he wants to postpone it is because the economy is such an important issue. He understands that right now, by margin of for every two people, one person thinks the GOP is responsible for this tanking
economy.
But
Mike, right now the debate on Friday night is supposed to be about foreign policy and not the economy.
I understand. But he has to solve the economy issue because the American public holds the GOP responsible. They hold him responsible, Bush responsible. He's in deep water by the polls.
Okay, Michael Reagan. If Barack Obama wants to do so much for the economy, why doesn't he go to his day job and work in the U.S. Senate? John McCain's going to do that while Barack Obama continues debate prep and shows up at the White House.
Well, what's interesting is Barack Obama hasn't written any piece of legislation to solve the problem. People need to remember that Nancy Pelosi and Harry Reid have been in charge of Washington for 2 years. They have done absolutely nothing. It's their friends that ended up making tens of millions of dollars off of Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, Franklin Raines, Jamie Gorelick, Jim Johnson. You can go through the list of these people.
Sure.
I think what America wants is somebody to make the perp walk. Listen, when Ken Lay did what he did to Enron, he ended up going to jail. When WorldCom cooked the books, Ken Ebbers ended up going to jail. Right now, we're being asked to pay $700 billion, but nobody's going to jail.
Yeah.
Everybody's going
to
having a great time.
What, Mike?
And it's not, America doesn't want to bail out the Jim Cramers of the world.
Hey Michael. Think back about another perp walk that should have taken place. That's where John McCain was involved with the Charles Keating Five scandal.
That's great, Mike. Let's go back to the 1980s.
You know what? Because it was about bailout.
Michael,
thing the Republicans
are
doing
now. Put a cork in it. In the 1980s.
Keating is important. Has everything to do with what's happening today.
Papantonio, pipe down.
I knew you guys were bringing this. That's the 1980s. We're now in the 2008.
Right.
Welcome to the presidential campaign.
Excuse me.
John McCain did not walk away with $90 million, be told to put back $40 million. He didn't walk away with $75 million.
Mike Papantonio, you are rude. Let him talk.
He did not walk away with millions and millions of dollars.
Oh, really?
John McCain did. Did John McCain make a mistake?
Guys,
absolutely right.
There.
Was he censured by Senate? Absolutely.
Three people went to prison in the Keating event. Here's what happened. Here's the quick news.
This is not the History Channel. Folks know what happened.
Surprise.
All right, we're going to end it right there. We thank you very much, guys, for joining us live. Next time, one at a time. We'll be right back.